Hello again. Hello. I don't know what camera am I looking at? Well, here we are again. In fact, this is only a wobbly camera again. Yeah, I need to figure this out. You don't want to listen? I forgot, you're deaf. Well, after recording that first video, I thought I'd probably do another one already. You see how this can escalate very quickly. I've got quite an addictive personality. Give me a golf club, I'll go and buy a set of TaylorMade within a day. Yeah, I thought I'd tell you what I do, photographically at least anyway. But my journey in photography, it started when, do you actually, that's a lie. It could be way, way before I thought. Child, having this, is a film camera. I think it is a fake SLR, if I remember rightly. The lens didn't change the focus. I think that changed. I can't remember. I seem to remember having different settings, but it looked like an old SLR camera. And I've got a vivid memory of being at a country park back down where we used to live, near Heathrow. An old search and rescue Wessex went over. That's a helicopter, for anybody who doesn't know. And I remember taking pictures of it. I think I enjoyed it. But it never continued. I don't know what happened to that roll of film. Probably never got developed. It's probably still in the camera in a landfill somewhere, unfortunately. But yeah, as a child, my parents, they always had a really big moving box, and it was filled with just 6x4 prints, Polaroids, etc. And I think that's where a fascination really started. And then my old man, my son was born back in 2011. And my dad gave me an old DSLR, a Canon 350D, and I thought it was the best thing ever. He picked himself up a 7D or something. Back then, honestly, they're all the same. And that was it, hooked. And that's kind of where my project, although I didn't know at the time, started. Just photographing my son, life a little bit. And then I went through all of the phases of photography. So I started doing a bit of landscape because it is what I thought easy. Turns out not so. People who are good at that, they are very good. I would take a landscape photo now, but there's certainly nothing special with it, I can tell you that. What else do I do? A bit of wildlife photography. Actually, thinking now, I wouldn't mind doing that again. Love nature, love wildlife, so it makes sense, especially birds of prey, of which we have, where we live here in Oxfordshire, absolutely plenty, an abundance. We even have peregrine falcons that we often hear out in the garden. They're up on the power lines. That's pretty cool. We've had sparrowhawks visit the garden, woodpeckers. So just in my back garden, you could have an absolute field day. If you watched the previous video, you will see I ramble. Yeah, back to point. So I dabbled in that. A little bit of aviation photography. My dad's a plane spotter, for those in America. You must have plane spotters. I don't know. But he is one of those. Nothing wrong with it. He loves aviation, and that's where I get my fascination with it as well. I should have been a pilot. So yeah, then I started dabbling in portraiture. Just there, shooting models. A little bit of fashion work. Primarily, the thing I enjoy most is doing long-term projects. And the biggest one was documenting my family. I think the last decade is when I really got serious about it. And I accumulated over 8,000 pictures, maybe even more, 10,000. Let's call it 10,000. And that's taken 10 years to get together. And it's funny, I was saying to my wife, I was going through those photos this year, month by month, just trying to pick out the good ones and edit them down. I wanted to get to about 500 images and then go through again, repeat, but that is now on hold. So, yeah. But aside from that, I do work on other projects. I have one I'm working on now, but I'm not going to tell you anything about it. Me and a group of friends, we had a little photography collective where we... It's called VN Collective, Visual Noise. It's good. But that kind of stopped for no reason. Maybe we'll try and get back together again and work on some more projects. But that, yeah, we worked on some short-term projects just to, I don't know, I think it's just to get a feel for going out into the field a little bit and working, going into the field. It's not like we're on assignment, but getting out and actually working to build a body of work that you can put together. We quite enjoy, I can't speak for the other guys, but I really enjoyed the challenge of saying, I don't know, set a target for 2 weeks to have 10 images. And whilst that might sound easy, it is quite a challenge because I'm very judgmental on myself. I'm very self-critical. I know when I've taken a bad image, which is probably 99%. So yeah, trying to do it in 2 weeks in between work, weekends, family, etc. And any other hobbies, golf, fishing. Yeah, proved quite a challenge. But so yeah, I do work on projects. I've got there's a project I've been working on for the last, since 16, 17. And that is just all about the sea. My childhood was a lot of it was by the seaside in some of those, down Hastings or Dorset. So it feels quite natural for me to try and document life by the sea, by the coast. And again, like I said, there is another project that I'm working on currently, but shtum. I won't be sharing any of that work. Not for a long time. I can envisage that being a good 4 or 5 years. Maybe longer, maybe less. It depends how much time I can dedicate. What I need to do is stop having so many hobbies. I really enjoy golf. Haven't played in 7 months because I think I broke a rib playing golf or damaging tissue or muscle or something in the ribs. Wherever it was, it really, really hurt and I haven't played since. Fishing? Yeah, I'm not going to stop that. I enjoy that far too much. So yeah, I thought I'd give a little bit of a background into myself. I know this was a complete ramble and a waffle and you've probably stopped watching already, but if you didn't, well done. Yeah.